Hey there, I thought I would create a little painting video. I created this glass, painted this glass the other day at work. It's a little dandelion and just kind of made me happy. And so I'm kind of focusing on happy things for now because, you know, it's crazy right now. So I got a little blues in the background and yeah, I thought we could maybe paint this together. Other things that I have with me, just a couple of plastic cups of water to clean my brushes in between changing colors of my paint. The paint is very inexpensive acrylic paints. These are the colors that I'm using, but really, you can use whatever colors you want. We're going to be painting this dandelion today and have an assortment of paint brushes and some extra paper towels just in case we make a mess. All right, keep that blues playing. Keeping myself happy. So I discovered that in painting glass, which I've never done before, softer brushes are a little easier because acrylic paints dry very quickly. So if your stiff brush, which I'm going to use a stiff brush to start with creating this stem, and that will help create a nice solid line. But if your brush is too dry, it's actually going to scrape the paint off of your glass. But it's a good thing to get it at least drawn out and started onto your glass. And I also like mixing colors because mixing colors is fun. Got a little bit of iridescent green in there. Other ways you can get that on there, you can just kind of dab it on there. Once you've got your line created. And then I'm going to do some of these little leaves and things that are on the side there. And again, I'm just kind of dabbing it on there. Getting a lot of paint on there. I'm going to add a little bit more lighter colors just to add a little bit of texture. All right, so that's good for now. And now I'm just going to get a little bit of yellow in there. And I might start with a darker color here. And just kind of dabbing that on there. And that's pretty much it for now on that. Slightly OCD, so when I say I'm done, I'm really not done. Okay, then, now, to create your little flowery part of the dandelion, a softer brush is actually going to be way more helpful to create the flowery part of your dandelion. So, this is a super soft brush. I don't know if you can see all of that, but it will help get that onto your glass a little bit easier. And how I'm doing this is I'm going to draw a line. And then create a little U, which it's not going to go on the glass now, but I'm trying to show you how to do it. And then the next thing I'm going to do is just going to take my little sponge and kind of soften that a little bit. And look at that, isn't that kind of fun? So I'm just going to keep that process going. I'm going to get a little more paint on my brush because it's a little bit dry. There we go. And you just keep on going all the way around. And then create another U. It doesn't have to be perfect because again, you're gonna just kind of sponge it to soften it. Just like that. I'm just gonna go all the way around it. Just keep it going. And then another little sponge, same process all the way around. Because again, acrylic dries really quickly. So you don't want to get it too dry before you touch it with a sponge. Not that it can't be fixed once you get it started. Anything can always be fixed. And I'm just going to kind of cheat on this one. There we go. softening. Oh yeah, good blues. Just keeping on, keeping on. I think this might be B.B. King. Sounds like the great B.B. King singing back there. Hanging on to that happy. Yes, you is so mean to me. You're so mean to me. Yeah, got the blues. Yes, you is so mean to me. Mm. Now you know that I love you. Keep on going on around. Filling it in however you want to fill it in. I'm going to cheat and go this way a little bit with that. Softening again. And then after you get your first layer, then I'm just going to add the next continuing layers going around, giving it a little more fullness. Got a little paint on my table there. Oops. Don't tell my husband. All right. Now, another fun thing with painting with glass is if you're like, oh man, I really hate that, you can just let it dry and pretty much just scrape it off with a butter knife or fingernail or whatever you got around the house, really, that can scrape that off. Oh yeah, we're starting to get a nice little shape in there. Nice little fluffiness in the dandelion here. And just like snowflakes, no dandelions are the same. Just keep filling in your lines and making it as fluffy as you want. Yeah, it's starting to come together real nice. Now, the next step that we're going to do after I get this all filled in is if you want to add a little bit of depth to your dandelion, we're also going to add a little bit of black in there, a little low lights, just to give it a little extra dimension. A little fluff in there, a little fluff in here. Go just a little more, a little fuller in here. And here.
here.
Now, that's looking pretty good. So the next thing I think I'm going to do is we're going to use a little bit of black, actually. A little black, a little green. Mixing the colors, it's all good. Because again, we're going to hit that with our sponge to kind of soften it up. I'm just adding a little bit of, I'm going to blot my brush just a little bit so it's not quite so saturated. And we're just adding a little bit of texture in there. In our stems. And then the same thing, just going to carry that through. Just giving it a little bit of texture. Just kind of dotting that on there. A little extra concentration just around this center here. And then I'm just going to soften all of that with our sponge again. Now, got my brush that I had yellow on. Gonna add a little more texture to the center here. Adding a little more brightness to that. And might even want to add some of that yellow to our leaves. Again, just giving it a little more texture. Just for funsies. I'm going to add a little bit of white to that center, giving it a little highlight. Just a little bit. Alright, now, as I mentioned before, slightly OCD, so I'm going to just make this just a little fuller, adding a few more fluffs to our dandelion. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Now, I'm going to go back with that black. Again, just giving it a touch more texture, detailing. Let's move that out just a little bit. Okay, now I'm going to go back in. I'm going to clean out this black a little bit. And I'm going to add the rest of my leaves to my glass. And it's got a little black in there, but I'm just going to get off of there. Easy peasy. All right, let's add a little more green. Green is good. And what's kind of fun is, like, when you start with a color, you can add another color, and then as it just smooths out on your glass, it creates its own colors. So blending your colors is a good thing. And back into that. Again, just kind of layering and going over it, and look at that, isn't that kind of fun? You can throw in a little bit of black in there if you want. Gives it a little extra dimension. Layers, like grass. And then put a little bit of light in there. And that's kind of what it looks like inside. Happy. And then if you wanted to, you can, I'm going to soften this up here. This line in here got a little icky. You can paint your stem, but I'm not going to do that right now because I want to be able to hold the glass up so you can see it. Yeah, just adding a little bit of lighter colors in here and texture. Okay. So basically, that's it. Now, how to preserve your glass. You can bake it in your oven, but you have to turn your oven on to 350 degrees. What I did with this one is I turned the oven on and set this in the oven upside down and baked it for 30 minutes. So you have to let it be in the oven as the oven is heating up. And then you also turn the oven off after 30 minutes and let it cool down inside your oven. And here are the directions to that. But yeah, it's just kind of a fun little happy project to brighten your day. And I hope this was fun for you. All right.